Hello everybody, my name is Walter, and today I want to show you how you can build a portal nexus inside of the nether that contains a hidden portal. So let's quickly show this. Let's first get to the nether, to this build right here. So as you can see, it contains four visible portals. Each has a button on one side, which when you press it, will deactivate all of the portals or reactivate all of the portals, depending on whether they are currently on or off. Each of those portals is linked to a single portal on the overworld. So as you can see, those are the four portals in the overworld. And each is linked to one of those visible portals right here. But there is actually a fifth one hidden inside of it. And to get to that, you need to know a few things. The first is you need to know what kind of key item you need. Then you need to know from which side you need to approach this. And then finally you need to know how to do this. So the first step is turning off the portals. Then the next step is putting the key item inside of this dispenser at the bottom, which contains the lava bucket. While doing so, or when you have done so, those blocks here on the side of this will retract for a very short moment. So you have just a very short amount of time to get through, and then you are at the fifth portal. So let me quickly get into the correct game mode, and then let's put in our key item, and let's actually put it in there, and then as you can see now I got through this door and am at the fifth portal, which is hidden in here and has some additional treasure. The other portals are a bit above this whole setup here. Now if I go in the opposite direction, the portal should be closed in the center again. And let me quickly get back to the creative mode. So as you can see, now I am on the outside again and this entire thing has done its job. So this is basically how you can use the setup. As you can see, I also have my key item back, which I got back at the same moment where I actually went through this door. And that's basically what this build here does. Now let's talk about the sizes while we're here. So this entire build is 8 blocks by 8 blocks as a footprint, plus the buttons to the outsides. And it has a total height of 7 blocks, which makes this pretty much very compact. There is actually no circuitry that goes above the top layer of those portal frames here. So you can put a completely flat ceiling on top of that, or roof on top of it. And that's the sizes. Now let's quickly get to the required resources. So let's quick go over there and let's look at our little chest here. So if you want to build this nether portal nexus, you're gonna need obviously some building blocks. There should be something that fits into the theme of the nether, so some nether bricks or similar. Then you're gonna need 100 obsidian blocks. So this is just for the 10 portals you're gonna need to build. Then 10 glowstone blocks. Those are somewhat optional, but it's a good idea to keep the space lit up to keep mobs from spawning. Then you're gonna need 2 stairs, one of which will be visible at a later point. Then you're gonna need your named items, which are the key items, and you're gonna need 24 for the system itself and at least 1 to use the system. For redstone circuitry, it's 29 redstone dust, 5 redstone torches, 12 repeaters, 3 comparators, 10 observers, 2 node blocks, 11 sticky pistons, 10 dispensers, 2 droppers, 4 hoppers and 4 buttons. I am showing stone buttons here, but you can also use any other kind of button. And then you're gonna need at least 5 flint and steel, and 5 lava buckets. And that's pretty much all you're gonna need. So Now it's time to show you how to build the Nexus. Okay, so the first step is placing down 5 Nether portals within the Nether. They need to be in the configuration you can see here. So basically 4 forming an outer square with a side length of 8 blocks or 6 blocks in between opposite portals. The portals are all 2 blocks wide and 3 blocks high, by the way. And then we have a 5th one in the center, basically, with a 1 wide gap to one of the outer ones. If you have placed everything correctly, you should be able to find a corner where you can place just a block here, and that is then diagonal to the center block and 2 outer blocks, or outer portals. Now, the next step is a bit more annoying. You need to place down 5 portals in the overworld, which are linked one each to those portals here. The outer ones need to be V-direction linked. So this means if I go in this portal here, I come out in the corresponding portal on the outside, on the overworld. And if I go in the opposite direction, I come out in the portal I just went in before. The portal in the center only needs to link from this portal here to the 5th portal on the overworld, which I have hidden, in this case, below the entire plane. And the opposite direction is not necessarily linked with this portal here. So if you have linked up bidirectional the outer 4, that is more or less enough. For the center one, it only needs to link from the Nether into the corresponding portal in the overworld. So now the way to properly link up portals has changed a bit during the different Minecraft versions. So that means I can't promise that what I will explain now will actually work in future Minecraft versions. So if it's not working out for you, I would actually recommend watching a tutorial for your current version or maybe looking in the Wikipedia. Anyway, how does the linking up work? It's pretty simple. You go into the Nether, and then in the F3 menu, you look in the coordinates for one of the blocks below the 2 white portal. And then you take the X coordinate and the Z coordinate and multiply both with 8. And that together with the unchanged Y coordinate is the corresponding location on the overworld. And this portal here will basically link to the portal on the overworld that is the closest to those coordinates. If you go in the opposite direction, you will simply divide X and Z by 8. And that's basically how you can link up those portals. Once you have built and linked up all portals, it's time to start with the circuitry. For that, I would recommend first turning off those portals and then starting on the side where we have this double portal. The first step is going towards the left side, and here we place a temporary block below the center portal. Now we can place 2 droppers facing upwards in front of that, and then we can remove our temporary block again. Next we place a hopper running into the bottom dropper, and then one running sideways. Just make sure it is not running into the dropper or into this hopper. Then on top of that, place a dispenser facing towards the front, and then 2 above that another dispenser. Then we go towards the inside, and here place a block going diagonally down like so. Put a comparator on top of it, which takes essentially an output from this hopper here. Run this into a full block, then with a 1 high gap we need a block below that. Then towards the right, we need 2 blocks here. Put down some redstone wire here, a repeater on 1 tick there, running into a full block with a torch to the side of it. Now you can place some of your named items in there. Let's start by placing in 4 items like so, and then 20 items like so. And then you should end up with 18 here, 1 here, and a last one in this dropper. And now if I were to place in another one, it should end up in this dispenser down here. Now let's go back to the inside here. And now add another three blocks here. Put down some redstone wire there. Then two repeaters on four ticks each, like so. And if I now place in the netherrack or whatever, I should get it back from this topper here. Next, let's go back to the center here. First, add two blocks to this row there. Then go up one layer. Put down two redstone wire and a repeater on four ticks here. Then put a block in front of this redstone wire. Torch on top, block on top, and some redstone wire on top. Grab three sticky pistons and place them in this place there. So now they extend and are flush basically with the side of this portal. Then go back to this side here, or this inside there. Put another block here with another repeater on four ticks in this direction, running into a full block with a torch towards the inside. Then next to this torch we need a full block with some redstone dust on top. Then place down four blocks in a row there. Put a comparator here, another one there. Then put down two hoppers facing each other in between. Now we need two torches on the sides of those blocks. Then a raised and around the corner lowered block here. Some redstone dust on top of this block. Place a sticky piston in front of this torch there, and then another one inside of this corner there. Now place a full block in there, and then put 12 items inside of those hoppers here. Then we need another sticky piston next to this redstone dust here. Make sure this stays in the cross shape. And in front of that, we need an observer, like so. After that, let's go back to this corner here. Place a block on top of this repeater here, next to this redstone cross there. Then opposite of the redstone wire, we need a sticky piston with an observer running into this direction. Then on top of here, we need a repeater on three ticks. Observed with an observer from this side, which runs into a full block. Then on top of our observer, we need a repeater on one tick, running into a full block with some redstone dust on top. And then we need a full block behind the repeater there. Then go in here and place a dispenser here and here. So basically same position as before. Then while we're here, let's actually close up this space and this space here. Since those will be somewhat visible at some point, you may want to use blocks that are colored fitting to your entire scheme going on the outside. Then let's go to our double portal again. And on the right side of that, we need a block on the outside and on the outside of the next portal diagonal to that. Those are the blocks where we can place our buttons. Then, below the one with the double portal, just go two blocks down, put some redstone wire here. Then next to that we need a full block there. And below the other one we need a sticky piston facing downwards with an observer running into this block down there. Then go behind this block. First a layer down, put a repeater on one tick right there, running into a full block with another full block there. Then go in here, put some redstone dust there, a repeater on one tick there, and that runs into a full block with a sticky piston on top of it. And then let's go to the opposite side here. Once more we place our two blocks with the buttons right there. Now on the right side we go two blocks down, place our block with the redstone dust on top, then the block next to the redstone wire, then a sticky piston facing downwards again. This time the observer is running into this direction here, which then runs into a full block, followed by a node block, an observer, another full block with some redstone dust on top. Then here we have next to the redstone dust another node block and then a last observer which should run into the block below this sticky piston here. Then on top of the sticky piston we need a full block, an observer, which runs directly into a full block. Then to either side of that we need lowered blocks with repeaters on three ticks taking an output. Then an observer looking at this repeater here running into a full block. Then again lowered blocks to the two sides, put redstone dust on top of those. Then on this side we do the same, so observer looking at the repeater running into this obsidian block here. And then again we have the lowered blocks basically with redstone dust on top of that. And now we're already at this point, we can start placing our missing dispensers. So at the double portal we have them on the right side, then on the left side, then again on the right side, so basically where we have those redstone dots or crosses going on, and then we are back to the left side again. Like so. Now let's quickly finish this. So from this double portal, go towards the portal on the left. Here grab your first stairs block and place them next to the top dispenser. This needs to be a transparent block since we don't want to connect this redstone wire to this dispenser here. You can use another transparent block if you want. I just think that the stairs is somewhat the cheapest option there. Anyway, let's grab a few more blocks and let's start with three blocks in a row going towards the back when you're looking from this double portal. Put redstone dust on top of those three blocks and this dispenser here. Then another block here and here, so we now have a four wide redstone line we can place here. Then we go down again, and if or once you reach this point here between the two dispensers, we need our other upside down stairs block here and then another block here. And now all you need to do is run this redstone line all the way over here, then also some redstone dust on top of this dispenser, a full block here to cut off this wire, then another full block right here, and a repeater on one tick in this direction. And that's pretty much all of the circuitry done. So now it's time to start filling in those dispensers. So in all dispensers at the bottom, you simply place a lava bucket, and in all of the other dispensers at the top, you can place at least one flint and steel, or I would actually recommend filling it completely. So once you have done it, it's time to test if everything works properly. For that, let's start by first turning on everything by simply pressing one of the buttons. Now all four portals on the outside should be turned on. The portal on the inside should be turned off. If we now flick one of the other buttons, so let's go to the opposite side from before to see if this signal line works. Now all portals should be turned off again. Now if we go in here and actually let's stand right in the center here, let's place our key item in there, and now you should see this here turning on. After some time it should turn off automatically again, as you can see here. And also the portals on the outside should also be turned on, and if we just press the button once more, they should turn off again. So that means that this is now working properly, which means now it's time to actually start filling in all of those spaces here. And for that I would actually recommend placing a line of glowstone blocks in the center of the back wall. At least the blocks next to those redstone dots here or redstone crosses here need to be transparent blocks. And the other ones can be pretty much any kind of block you want. So let's quickly do this. And let's actually replace this one here with something that fits a bit better into the color scheme. And with that, the outside is pretty much finished, or at least the portals are pretty much finished. All that's missing is actually building the rest of the portal up so it's not looking as ugly. So maybe at least replacing those blocks with the buttons and obviously put in a floor and a ceiling and some walls around the circuitry. And voila! So now as you can see, everything is nicely finished up. I decided to use, for example, some polished blackstone buttons instead of the normal stone buttons since they fit a bit better into the overall theme. But I am far from being a master of making things look somewhat nice. Anyway, it at least is completely functional and works as it's supposed to. And with that, we have finally reached the end of this tutorial about this portal nexus with a secret portal. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial and well, see ya!